Well, a water war is brewing between all of us here in Central Florida and our neighbors to the north.
As our water supply continues to dwindle under pressure from growth, people are looking toward the St. Johns River as a possible solution. WESH News' Dave McDaniel looks at the effort to hammer out an agreement over who has the right to the water and whether river water should be used at all.
Many say our water is running too freely. Are we at risk of running out?
There's just so much fresh water available.
To meet demand, many are looking to the St. Johns River. A test plant proved river water could be treated to drinking water standards, but it'll cost us. Right now, aquifer water can cost as little as $1.50 per thousand gallons. River water would cost twice as much, at least $3.50 per thousand. And treating ocean water between $6 and $9 per thousand, exactly why river water is considered the cheaper option. But North Florida leaders fear our plans to use the St. Johns will leave them dry. Our experts disagree.
It's clear after 10 years of study of the river that there is that possibility with no harm to the downstream users.
And while the elected officials debate how much water can actually be taken out of the river to be used here in Central Florida and still have enough left for North Florida, there are some who believe we can cut the river out of the equation entirely.
There's really no need to be trying to suck our rivers dry.
The Audubon Society says the recent push to change landscaping laws to demand more drought-tolerant plants is how we stretch our existing supply.
50 to 70% of the water that we take out of every well field is being wasted, and that's where the water should be harvested.
The future is now when it comes to meeting demand. Dave McDaniel, WESH 2 News.
Thank you.